Good morning, student. Today we are going to solve exercise 3.3 of understanding quadrilateral. Question number 3. Can quadrilateral ABCD be a parallelogram if angle D plus angle B is equal to 180 degree? Second part, AB is equal to DC is equal to 8 centimeters, AD is equal to 4 centimeters, BC is equal to 4.4 centimeters. Third part is angle A is equal to 70 degree and angle C is equal to 65 degree. First we need to know property of parallelogram. In parallelograms, opposite sides are equal, opposite angles are equal, and diagonal bisect each other. Adjacent angles are supplementary. Okay, so let's see the figure of parallelograms ABCD and AB is equal to CD, AD is equal to BC, opposite angle A is equal to angle C, and angle B is equal to angle D. Okay, so let's see solution of this question. Okay, so our first option is angle D plus angle B is equal to 180 degree. In this condition, the given quadrilateral ABCD is a parallelogram. Okay, so you can see in this quadrilaterals, angle B and angle D both are opposite angles. Okay, so their sum is 180 degree, but in the parallelograms, property as parallelograms, but the properties of parallelograms is sum of adjacent angles are supplementary. Okay, so angle A adjacent angle D and angle A adjacent angle B. So A plus B is 180 degree and also A plus D is 180 degree. Okay, so you can see here angle A plus angle B is equal to 180 degree. Clear? Because they are adjacent angle. If this is a given, then the given quadrilateral is parallelogram, but here opposite angle are sum of opposite angle are given. So it is can be parallelogram. Okay, but need not to be, but need not to be, but need not B. You can say maybe, may not be. Okay, means it's become parallelograms or it is not become parallelograms. Okay, so you can't fix anything because this is given, the sum of opposite angle is 180 degree. In the case of rectangles, it's become parallelograms. Okay, every rectangles is a parallelograms, but every parallelogram is not rectangles. Clear? So if opposite sum of opposite angle are 180 degree, then the given quadrilateral ABCD may be parallelograms, may not be parallelograms. Okay, now next condition, in second part, AB is equal to DC is equal to 8 centimeter. So you can see here, AB is equal to DC, okay, opposite side are equals, and AD is equal to 4 centimeters. This is AD, this is 4 centimeters, and BC is equal to 4.4 centimeter. This means that this is 4 centimeter and this is a 4.4 centimeter, okay. But in the parallelogram, opposite side are equals, okay. But in a parallelogram, opposite side are equal. So it means that the second part, AB is equal to DC, given that AB is equal to DC, this is 8 centimeter, and this is also 8 centimeter. So this is equal, okay. But AD is equal to this, BC is not equal, so this is not parallelograms, okay. Here you can see opposite side are not equal, but in parallelograms opposite side are equal, okay. AB is equal to DC, this is okay, but AD is equal to BC. AD is given 4 centimeter and BC is given 4.4 centimeter, so this is not equal, opposite side are not equal, so this is not parallelograms, okay. The quadrilateral ABCD is not a parallelogram. Now let's see third part. Angle A is equal to 70 degree and angle BC is equal to 65 degree. So here this is angle A, 70 degree, this is angle C, 65 degree, clear, okay. So in parallelograms opposite angles are equal, but here you can see angle A does not is equal to angle C, okay. So this is the given quadrilateral is not parallelograms, okay. So the given quadrilateral is not parallelograms, okay. Now we are going to check and solve question number 5. This is question number 5. The measure of two adjacent angles of a parallelogram are in the ratio 3:2. Find the measure of each of the angles of parallelograms. So we know that according to the properties of parallelograms, adjacent angles are supplementary, okay. It means that sum of two adjacent angles are 180 degree. So here we let the angles be 3x and 2x, okay. So 3x plus 2x is equal to 180 degree, because this is a adjacent angles of parallelograms. 3x plus 2x is equal to 5x, so 5x is equal to 180 degree, because they are supplementary. So x is equal to 180 degree by 5, means 36 degree. So in this way, find the measure of each angles of the parallelograms, okay. And you know very well the opposite angle of parallelograms are equals, clear. So let's see how to solve it. This is a parallelograms ABCD. Angle A is equal to angle C and the angle D is equal to angle B, okay. Angle A is adjacent of angle B. Angle A is also adjacent of angle D. Angle B is adjacent of angle C, and angle C is adjacent of angle D and B also, okay. So first we let the angles are 3x and 2x. So we let the adjacent angle are 3x and 2x. Angle A adjacent to angle B. So suppose this is 3x and this is 2x, and they are adjacent angle. So angle A plus angle B, angle A plus angle B is equal to 180 degree. Okay, so we'll get angle A is equal to 3x plus angle B is equal to 2x is equal to 180 degree. Clear? Or 3x plus 2x is 5x is equal to 180 degree. Clear? Now x is equal to 180 degree by 5. Clear? R x is equal to 5 3 15 and 30. 5 6 30. X is equal to 36 degree. So in the parallelograms, opposite angle are equal. This is also 2x and this is also 3x. Okay, according to property of parallelograms, opposite angle are equal. So angle A is equal to angle C and angle D is equal to angle B. Clear? So angle A is equal to angle C is equal to 3x. Okay, but here we find the value of x is 36 degree. 3 into 36. So here we obtain 3 6 18, 21, 3 3 9 1 10. Okay, so we obtain angle x A and angle C is equal to 180 degree. Now angle B and angle D. Angle B is equal to angle D is equal to angle what? 2x will get. But the value of x we find 36. Okay. So 36 to the 72 degree. Okay, in this way we find all angles of parallelograms. Angle A is equal to angle C is 108 degree and angle B is equal to angle D is 72 degree. Clear? Now let's see one times more. This is given. Two adjacent angles are given in ratio 3:2. Okay, so you will get the adjacent angles are 3x and 2x. According to the properties of parallelograms, adjacent angles are supplementary. So angle A plus angle B is equal to 180 degree. Okay, and opposite angles are equal. So angle A is equal to angle C and angle B is equal to angle D. Clear? So angle A 3x and angle B is 2x. So here 3x plus 2x is equal to 180 degree. 3x plus 2x is 5x. Clear? So x is equal to 180 degree by 5. Here we find x is equal to 36 degree, and put the value of x. So we find the angle of A and the angle of C, both are equal, both equal to 3x. So 3 into 36, this becomes 108 degree. And now angle B is equal to angle D because opposite angle of in parallelograms, opposite angle are in parallelograms are equal. So angle B and angle D are opposite angle. Okay, so it is equal, both are equal, is equal to 2x. But we find here the value of x is 36 degree. So angle B is equal to angle D is equal to 72 degree. In this way, you find the value of all angle of the parallelograms, angles A, B, and angle D, A, B, C, D. Okay, this is, you can see here. Now we are going to solve question number 6. Question number 6. Two adjacent angles of a parallelogram have equal measure. Find the measure of each of the angles of the parallelogram. Here two times we write angles by mistake. Two adjacent angles of a parallelogram have equal measure. Find the measure of each of the angles of parallelograms. Okay, so let's see, this is a parallelogram. Angle A and angle D are adjacent angle, clear? And angle A is equal to angle C, angle B is equal to angle D, because the opposite angle of a parallelogram are equal. But here given, adjacent angles are equal in measure. So angle A is equal to angle D. Clear? Let's see how to solve it. Here let adjacent angle be X. Okay. So this angle be X. So adjacent angle of this is also X. Okay. So angle D is opposite angle of B. This is also X. And angle A opposite angle of C. This is also X. Okay. So opposite angle of parallelograms are equal. So angle A is equal to angle C. Angle D is equal to angle B. Okay. And according to the properties of parallelograms, adjacent angles are supplementary. It means that angle A plus D is equal to 180 degree. Okay. So you write according to the angle A plus angle D is equal to 180 degree. Clear? This is a property of parallelograms. Adjacent angles are supplementary. But here we let both Rx equal in measure. Also X is equal to 180 degree. X plus X is 2X. Clear? Is equal to 180 degree. X is equal to 180 degree by 2. Clear? Or X is equal to 90 degree. Okay, so you can see here angle A is equal to 90 degree. Also angle B is equal to 90 degree, because each angle are equal to X. Angle C is equal to 90 degree. Angle D is equal to 90 degree. Okay, so first we let the adjacent angle be X, but in the parallelograms opposite angle are equal, so each angle becomes X. Okay, and according to properties of parallelograms, we know that adjacent angles are supplementary. So angle A plus angle D is equal to 180 degree. But angle A and angle D both are X. Will it? So X plus X is 2X is equal to 180 degree. And we find X is equal to 90 degree. So you can see this figure. Each angle is equal to X. And we find X is equal to 90 degree. So each angle becomes 90 degree. Okay, clear? Now we are going to solve question number 7. This is question number 7. Question have that sent figure HOPE is a parallelogram. Find the angle, measure X, Y and Z. State the properties you use to find them. So see, this is figure HOPE. We find the value of X, Y and Z. Okay, clear? You can see angle 70 degree is the exterior angle of HOP. Okay, so exterior angle is equal to sum of opposite interior angle of a triangles. Okay, this is clear. And 40 plus Z is equal to 70 degree because this is a corresponding angle. Okay, let's see how to find it. In figure, in triangle, what is this angle? This angle is, this is becomes straight angle. So this is 180 degree. Okay, but here this is given 70 degree. So this angle is equal to, this angle is equal to 180 degree minus 70 degree. Okay, so it's become 110 degree. Clear? Because HOPE is a parallelogram, so angle E is equal to angle O. Okay, here you find angle O is equal to Y, opposite angle of parallelograms are equal. Clear? This property is used. So here angle E is equal to 110 degree. Clear? Opposite angles of parallelograms are equal. So in this figure you can see angle E is equal to angle O, and this angle is equal to 110 degree because this whole angles are straight angles. In this angles have two part, this is linear pair. Okay, so one part is 70 degree, second part is 180 minus 70 degree, it's become 110 degree. Clear? And opposite angle are equal in parallelograms. According to the property of parallelograms, opposite angle are equal. So angle E is equal to angle O. So angle E is X. So angle E is X. So this become 110 degree. Okay, now in triangle HOP. Okay, now in triangle HOP. Okay, suppose here this is a. Okay, so angle A. Okay, angle APO, angle A पी एंगल एओपी इंटर एंगल एचओपी एंगल एओपी इज एक्सटीरियर एंगल इज एक्सटीरियर एंगल सो एंगल ए ओ पी इज इक्वल टू एंगल ओ पी एच प्लस एंगल ओ एच पी वाई एक्सटीरियर एंगल इज द सम ऑफ अपोजिट इंटीरियर एंगल्स क्लियर सो दिस इज 70 डिग्री दिस इज 70 डिग्री एंड दिस इज कॉल्ड टू ओपीएच ओपीएच इज एंगल जेड एंड ओ एच पी ओ पी एच इज एंगल वाई ओ पी एच ओ पी एच इज एंगल वाई ओ पी एच दिस एंगल वाई एंड ओ एच पी दिस एंगल जेड ओके सो यू कैन राइट एंगल ओ पी एच इज ओ पी एच एंगल वाई प्लस एंगल ओ एच पी इज जेड क्लियर बट इन दिस फिगर यू कैन सी हियर ई एच पैरेलल ओ पी ओके ई एच पैरेलल PU, okay, and HP is transversal. So angle this angle is equal to angle Y, okay. So this angle is equal to this angle. Alternate interior angle, clear? So you can write here Y is equal to 40 degree. Why? Because EH is equal to PU. ये क्या बन गया आपका अल्टरनेट इंटीरियर एंगल ओके सो वाई इज इक्वल टू 40 डिग्री क्लियर सो हियर वी फाइंड 70 डिग्री दिस इज एक्सटीरियर एंगल ऑफ दिस ट्रायंगल एच ओ पी एंड वाई प्लस जेड बट वी फाइंड द अबव वाई इज इक्वल टू व्हाट we find y is equal to 40 degree plus z clear or you can write 70 minus 40 degree is equal to z clear 70 minus 40 is equal to 30 degree is equal to z okay so you can write or z is equal to 30 degree okay so in this way we find the value of x hence we find the value of x is equal to 110 degree okay we use property opposite angle of a triangle opposite angle of a parallelogram are equal okay and y is equal to we find 40 degree, you use the property as alternate interior angle, and Z is equal to, you find 30 degree to use exterior angle of a triangle is sum of interior opposite angles. Okay, so I hope all have understood. Let's see. Once again, this is given. Okay, y is equal to 40 degree because this is a interior angles, alternate interior angle. Okay, and x is equal to this angle, this, because both sum of both angle is 180 degree. This is 70. Here you find this is a 110, and the opposite angle of the parallelograms are equal. So x is equal to 110. Now this 70 is the exterior angle of this triangle. 70 is equal to z plus y. We find the value of y is equal to 40 degree due to the alternate interior angles. Okay, so we find the value of z is 30 degree. Okay, so in this way we find the value of x, y and z is 110 degree, y is 40 degree and z is 30 degree. Thank you for watching.